Hi, I want to tell you the story about this train in particular that belonged to my dad. If you want to skip the story and just see the train in action, skip to 1320 in this video. My dad passed away last summer. He had a good long life. My mom wanted me to have his Lionel toy train. She said, "You like to tinker with things, see if you can get it working again." My dad used to get this train out at Christmas time and set up a track around the tree. He probably stopped getting it out about 30 years ago. I had forgotten that this train even existed. I remembered that you just pushed a button and the train would go. That was my perception as a kid. So I took the train and all the parts home. This is where I started. These had been boxed up in my parents' garage for decades. Everything was dusty, the plastic parts were cracked, some parts were missing. My dad saved things. He saved the original boxes the train cars were sold in. He saved the original documentation, though some of it was damaged by mice. This pamphlet from Union Pacific is a slice out of time. It's presented as if this is the way things are and would always be like this, but this time is gone. I think it's wonderful to have this memory and this record of that time. I'm so glad that he saved all of this. He saved wood filler and lubricant that had long since dried out. He saved bayonet bulbs, though I didn't even know that's what they were called yet. I was about to go down the rabbit hole into the world of Lionel trains. Thanks to you, Dad, for saving these, and thanks to my mom for sharing this with me. We started to clean up and repair things. We disassembled and cleaned the buildings. We glued up cracks. I found out why my dad gave up on this train. Of the 9 cars he had, only 2 of the knuckles worked. It's not much fun to play with the train if you can only link together 2 cars. I also found that the locomotive didn't work. Once I had power to the track, I tried to run it. This is the first time in decades that this train has been run. So let's try it out and see if it works. It only moved a few inches once. At some point, my dad decided it wasn't worth the effort to repair, and he stopped getting it out at Christmas time. I have some advantages that he didn't have. Thank you to YouTube and eBay. Thank you to those of you out there who shared videos about their trains and how to repair them. I learned what an E-unit is, how to connect 145 and 153 contactors, the difference between O and O27 track, the whole 9 yards. YouTube taught me all of this and how to disassemble, clean, and wire all the parts that I had. Thanks to eBay, I replaced missing parts and bought more lengths of track. My goal was to restore the train to the existing parts that my dad had. I didn't want anything newer or different or extra. Does Lionel make better trains now? Yes. Do they have more reliable transformers? Yes. Is it sometimes frustrating to play with a post-war train? Yes.
The wheels fall off the track, it shorts out, it stops all the time. You have to get up, go over to the train, line up the wheels, then come back to the transformer repeatedly. There are many interruptions to playtime.
But I didn't want something new or better. This is an experiment in sentiment and nostalgia. I wanted the train to open the doors to my memory and take me back in time. I wanted to hear the electric buzz and the train whistle, smell that greasy electric motor, and remember
the tree that my mom set up with red bows and strings of popcorn on it. And remember those childhood Christmases.
I want the memory of what my dad did for us to live on. So I thought my dad got this train as an adult when my siblings were little kids. I learned that this 2036 locomotive was made in 1950. So actually, he had this as a boy.
This would have been his toy growing up that he saved to share with his kids later on.
Now I get to share it with my kids. These trains are made to last. They are made of metal and very durable to use and abuse and repair, and they keep working. But we found some problems.
When I disassembled the locomotive, the hot and common wires were crunchy rather than flexible. No doubt there were many shorts in these wires, so I replaced them. The locomotive still didn't work, so I found a repair shop. This repair technician was amazing. He reminded me of the repairman in Toy Story that fixes up Woody. His repair shop was piled with train parts everywhere. He saw a part that I needed, and he found it in his drawer and replaced it right away. He had the train working in a few minutes. I learned from him
that each time you apply power, the train cycles forward, off, backwards, off. Simple stuff, but I didn't know that. When I was a kid, I thought you just push a button, right? His name is Chuck, and his shop is Only Three Rail in Hobbytown, USA, in Westminster, Colorado. It was a delight to watch him work, and this train wouldn't be running without his help. Thank you, Chuck. We solved other problems.
I replaced crunchy wire from the remote control track and the transformer. I soldered. We replaced lights and wiring on the signal bridge and replaced the missing man in the switch tower. We replaced the spout on the water tower. I riveted knuckle connectors and replaced trucks.
One problem was especially interesting. My brother said he remembers putting pellets in the smokestack and the train would make real smoke. Cool.
Except I read that this 2036 model does not have a smoke unit. It's not possible that my brother remembers this.
Not cool. I want my train to make real smoke. Can a smoke unit be added?
I ordered a smoke unit from eBay to try. Good news, it fit perfectly. I found that the bracket on the smoke unit was just the right size to fit between the top bar and the smokestack hole. And that there's still space for the light bulb in front of the smoke unit. There was already a hole in the train frame that perfectly lined up with the smoke unit bracket. After all, this train is similar to the 2026 that does have a smoke unit, so it feels like it was made to fit. I just soldered the smoke unit to the E-unit terminal, and it produced heat. This was going to work. Except now a little problem. There was no bracket for the piston to fit into, nowhere for it to attach. I solved this problem by cutting a strip of aluminum from a black soda can, looping it over, and pinching it between the nose piece and the main casing. The piston bar was held in place by these loops. One side of the bar rested on the driving rod, so each rotation of the wheels would push the bar, move the piston, and push air through the smoker for a little puff of smoke.
Now the train fits the memory more than the reality of our childhood. Remember, I'm restoring nostalgia more so than just the train. I found a website, megasteam.com, that makes smoke drops with different scents. The Christmas pine drops smell pretty good.
I found that two or three drops are enough to get the smoke going, especially if you buzz the E-unit for a minute and warm up the smoker before you start moving.
We got everything fixed and adjusted so the train can do dozens of laps without stopping. So this set has the 2036 locomotive with magnet traction wheels and an upgraded smoke unit. Coal tender with the whistle. an automatic refrigerated milk car that can deliver cans of milk, a lumber car, three tank cars, an open gondola car with barrels, and a red caboose. The stationary features are the illuminated freight station, the switch tower, the double signal bridge, the semaphore signal, the water tower, the control track and milk delivery platform, the block signal, and the girder bridge. Let's see the train in action. Enjoy. Thanks, Dad. Love you, Mom.
Thank you.